forgiveness is useless without forgiving. Because, see, it's the forgetting part that's the hard part. Forgiving, you know, it's something as believers we know we have to do. Amen? Jesus says, forgive those in the Lord's Prayer. Lord, we forgive those who sin against us. And it's common practice for a Christian to be forgiven, or he's supposed to. But where we fail and where we seem to get hung up is the forgetting part. And what we're about to read is when they were beating Jesus, it was all through the whole, you know, he was carrying his cross to Mount Calvary. And when they drove the spikes through his hand, this was the Lord's remark, and through his feet. In verse 34, may God bless the reading of his word, all God's children said. This is what Jesus said. Then Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And that right there, for they know not what they do, that's Jesus forgetting. Not holding on to it. He's saying, Lord, they don't know what they're doing. I know they don't know what they're doing, so please forgive me. And then he forgot me because it wasn't, I mean, could we, Sister Melvin, you knew you hadn't done anything wrong, and you, crucifixion was the worst type of death, and still is to this day, that a human can go through. Because it's not just the spikes that held the weight of their body, it's the internal organs crushing each other and suffocating you to death. It's a horrible death. And he was laying there, half beaten to death, with holes in his body, flesh tore off of him, no skin hardly left on him, on his back or his front side. And as they began to drive the spikes through his hands, through the cross, he said, Lord, he said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, I am so thankful to my Lord God that you remind me that just forgiveness isn't enough. Not only, Lord God, do you want us to forgive those who sin against us, forgive those who say something bad about us, forgive those who hurt our feelings, forgive those, Lord God, who, like a snake in the grass waiting to bite us, not only forgive those, Lord God, who we love, but they don't show it in return, you also expect us to forget it after we forgive it. Father, I pray we grasp the message tonight, what you're trying to tell us, Lord God, about how important it is to not get hung up, to not get caught up in our emotions and our feelings and not forget it. Because if we don't forget it, Lord God, eventually the forgiveness will be wiped out and we'll be right back where we started. Lead me tonight. Anoint me with them. Pentecost, the Holy Ghost, fire from heaven tonight, Lord Jesus. Speak to us. Lord, our ears are open. Our hearts are waiting. Our minds are clear. And we're here for you. We love you. We praise you. And we ask it in your precious and holy and wonderful name. And all God's children said, I know somebody who was a believer, a devout Christian, who was very, very strongly hurt by a female companion. And he said that the forgiving part was easy. You know, he told the Lord that he forgave her. He told her that he forgave her. But Miss Lena, every single time he saw her, he got sick in his stomach, and that feeling kept coming back. And he said it didn't matter how long the span was between Brother James seeing her or being around her or running into her, no matter where it was still gut-wrenching, and it tore him inside out. Jesus not only forgave them there, Jesus forgot about what they were doing to him. It had no impact on his life. Had no impact on him laying there, Brother Randy. He could have called legions of angels to come down from heaven on high and smite the entire nation. He could have got up and said, you know what, Father, this is, I'm not doing this. I know what J.R. is going to do. He's going to be with me for a while, and then he's going to walk away for a while. He's going to be doing what I need him to do and how I need him to do it, and then Brother Keith, he's going to go do what he wants to do. He's going to lay out a church on Wednesday night. He's going to lay out a church on Sunday. He's not going to be devoted. He's not going to be dedicated, and he's sure not going to be dependable, Father. So why would I lay here and go through what I have, knowing that he's not going to be what he's supposed to be? It's done. I'm not doing it. He could have got up, walked, and that been the end of it. But you know what, Brother James? Jesus didn't just forgive us. Jesus forgets about our sin. The minute we confess it, it is forgotten about. That's why, as believers, Sister Denise, we not only forgive, we forget. Now, I'm sure I'm the only one in here that has forgiven somebody but hadn't forgotten about it. I'm probably the only one. Amen? That is the hardest part. The forgiveness is the easy part. It's the forgetting we struggle with. Every time we see him, oh yeah, boy, let me tell you what they've done to me. Let me tell you what he said about me. Let me tell you what I told he made me do, and then I turned around and saw him not do it. Or family, that's the good one. Especially those family reunions or those cookouts, amen? Oh, Lord, here she comes. Oh, Lord, there he is. We ain't forgiven. We haven't forgiven them. We're still hung up on it. Because we haven't forgotten it. Brother Randy, am I wrong? Tell me if I am, brother. Forgiveness is easy. You know why? Because when we don't want to forgive them, what happens? The Holy Ghost says, did I not forgive you yesterday for this, that, and the third? And you're going to act like you don't have to forgive them. The minute we don't want to forgive them, the Holy Ghost immediately intervenes. And thank God he does. And reminds us of what we've been forgiven of for the past just one week. Let alone one time. So the forgiven part, it's like jump rope.
Requirement is of us. You know why he even created us. because there's so much involved for both of them to work together. And not only does God require us, Brother James, to forgive others, love our enemy and our neighbor. Forgiveness and forgiveness is. You forgive them and you forget about them. forget tonight.